The Swedes are still king. They're 7-0 in the group stage. The Alliance GG are undefeated. We go into game 8 now. They are looking to sweep Tongfu 2-0. I'm LD, and he's Lumi, and we're going to cast game 2. Let's jump into it.
And I'm very sad, too.
And he is. He's mourning the loss of the motherland.
Alliance, pick number 1. We'll select Lone Druid and Shadow Demon. Meanwhile, Tongfu is going to go with the Tried and True Alchemist. So we saw exactly how played it last game, right? He had a free farm lane, did not max Krivol's Greed, which is, I think, what came out a little bit strange or non-standard, because generally when you give Black, Havos, or any other Chinese one-row player, oh, you got a free lane. You could go max Krivol's Greed by 7. You could do that and get your, you know, 1,000 GPM. He instead rushed Alchemist Shadowblade and was ganking. In fact, on the first 10 kill, Hal was involved in all of them. His score was 307. That is impressive.
Yeah, I can't argue with that build. Like, the farming build's fine. It's nice. Some games, it's the way to go. But that game, they needed an impact Alk. He crushed Bulldog's Offlane Bounty Hunter, who just got completely shut down. They did it against Living Armor. They did it against a hero who's very hard to kill in the laning stage. They won in my opinion, they won the laning stage because they didn't lose it. Like, they're up against Living Armor, up against Weaver, Bounty Hunter, Timbersaw. You're supposed to lose those lanes.
Yep.
The Magnus offlane for Kinjay never died. Everything was going right for Tongfu, but then it came to the mid and late game decision making, and it just wasn't. Tongfu's decision making was not on the level of the Alliance's, and that was the difference.
Yeah.
Better decision making from the Alliance and more confidence just to take fights, even though I think Tongfu had the lineup that should have been more confident. And so we come into game 2, Tongfu, they have to know they were close. I mean, that much is obvious.
They knew they were close. They knew they were ahead.
Is their confidence, because there's two ways to look at it, right? One is like, we were close, we should have won, we're going to win this game. The other is, we were close, how the hell did we lose that game? Mm-hmm. What are we going to do now?
I think that depends on whether you're the DKs and Navis, or maybe a team that is just on the rise, you know?
And Tongfu is in that interesting position, right? Between the clear tier 1 teams with huge championship belts and histories and a wall full of medals and trophies, your Burnings, your Dendies, and so forth and so on. Tongfu, not super accomplished. Pandaren back in Dota 1 had some decent tournament wins, but they haven't won anything super major. They've never been viewed as a Banchua or anything like that.
Right. I mean, they walk into TI3 winning the DSL. That's their biggest and most recent accomplishment. You have Kinjay, one of the game's longest living legends, veterans in this.
Right. As an individual player, he's very
accomplished. Yeah, and he is the drafter. He is the captain. Let's see, I think, more than anything, how well he rallies his team. Come on, guys. We lost a tough one. It's okay. We could still beat Alliance.
And there was an interview about, I think it was either with Hao or Mu, one of the players who's been on the team for a while. Mm-hmm. And they talked about how different it's been having Kinjay. And the biggest thing they said is he's calm Alliance and he's stable. So the RPs in that game were pretty decent. I mean, the late game, he did not catch the Weaver and RP until once at the very end, but then it was too late.
I think that was more so S4 always finding him and making sure that RP never goes on.
That's fair.
First it was Chakram to disable Splink, and then it was Hexus prevent a BKB skewer. Yeah. S4 was playing out of his mind. Kinjay coming off from my offlane Magnus, landing those mid-game RPs, I think he has done his job.
Right, but I guess the thing is, the natural reaction for a lot of players would just be to get frustrated, right? If anyone can stay calm and cool, it sounds like it should be Kinjay. So let's see if he can now. We're going to get into the draft now. Game 2 is well underway. Tongfu, as far as their bans go, the pretty similar bans from them. They get rid of Wisp again. They're not going to let Alliance have that, which I think is very smart. And they go for an Alk first pick. Alliance quickly responds. This time, they don't go for the Tree Timber Saw. They go for Lone Druid Shadow Demon. So much more standard fare from Alliance. More what you're used to seeing from this team, their bread and butter. Then Tongfu says, we'll take a Darkseer next. And now we go into the second stage of bans. The Alliance removes OD from the equation. Great hero to pierce through the Lone Druid's tanky bear. A lot of burst damage. Hard to kill for their team, which has very few disables. Then they ban out a Visage. As for Tongfu, they remove the Timbersaw and the Chen. Alliance says, we still want our jungler. We're going to go Enchantress.
Yeah, this has the makings of a G1 League LAN final pick, where they just went offensive jungle Enchantress, give Admiral Bulldog a little bit of assistance, get a little bit of tower diving going on, and then, you know, you put your SD PA up top. They won't die. You have defensive blink, you have defensive disruption, you can farm with Spectral Dagger, and you put S4 mid.
So are they going to go for Shadow Demon Anti-Mage here, you think?
Shadow Demon PA, I think.
PA.
Depending whether they have that offensive trialing against them, I think.
I guess I think going Anti-Mage here is actually pretty risky, because you're up against Alchemist.
Sure.
And Early Shadowblade Alc can just ruin AM. And on top of that, if they do want to trade farm, Alc's one of the best heroes to do it with.
Yeah, I don't think they'll go back to the draft that they won the G1 land final with, because it just doesn't match that well against what Tongfu is doing. Tongfu right now has three cores that is good at laning, that has decent team fight, and really powerful mid game. Like, if Darkseer picks up a 10-minute mech or a 12-minute mech, you could suddenly start roll over the towers of Alliance. Now, Alliance, what they need to do is split push, and having Lone Druid as now Dragonite, oh.
A heavy dose of push. Yeah. And Tongfu are a bit lacking in counter push. Acid Spray is okay, but mech's going to mostly negate what that does to you, the heal as well as the plus armor, and you've got a Darkseer. That's about it for counter push. So Tongfu, I think this is where you think about a Jakiro, a very strong counter pushing hero, great synergy with Darkseer. They need AoE, they need counter push, and they need a support anyway.
I mean, there is also Keeper of the Light if they want the Blinding Light against all of these stuff.
That actually might be better, but they'll go Jakiro.
Okay. It's both
I
of them
think
are
one
very
of those were
heroes.
The way to go. Yeah.
Also, I actually think that Keeper of Light is a hero that you should always keep in mind against Lone Druid. I just talked about the Blinding Light. Illuminate, weaken the creep wave. Keep in mind that Monolith against the Druid, the bearer, is actually instant stun. So if you do level it up, it's a 2-second stun, I think, at max level against the Spirit Bear. So it's not bad to have it. We'll see if they do manage to pick it up later or if they're going to go with a different support.
You know, after watching that train wreck of a Lone Druid game yesterday for Zhou, where his bear died 7 or 8 times, I'm really interested to see how Bulldog does on the Lone Druid. Because he's been very successful. We've seen that when he gets Lone Druid, even in this patch, they generally win. Will he have that success here? They've got good heroes to gank the bear. Lots of minus armor, lots of physical damage. They have good lockdown, decent lockdown for it anyway. Can they shut him down? That's like the most interesting thing about this game, because everyone else who's running Lone Druid is not very successful. Alliance is the only team who, to me, is consistently finding success with that hero.
To me, it depends on whether the Chinese know how to deal with the creep pulling that he always does so well. I see other players do creep pulls early on with the bear. Like, I guess you know what I'm talking about, right?
You pull it. You creep skip, you drag the waves back.
Right, and you don't drag it in front of your tower. That's what most players do. He drag it between his tier 3 and tier 2.
Or tier 2 and tier 1.
Tier 2 and tier 1. And you are just absolutely safe in that particular position to farm. So let's see if they have certain support heroes, for example, are really good against that. SD, for example. You could use your poison to drag the neutrals.
Yeah,
and
towards
then,
it.
Right. I don't think Jakiro's that good, to be honest, in terms of stopping that. But
the other ones that are good are heroes like Venno that can just like gale it and then you right click it.
Yeah.
They don't really have the best supports to punish a bear. And an Alliance is going to do something a little bit clever.
Are they pulling a page of Navi's playbook?
So it's a Lota Morana now. They'll go for an S4 Dragonite mid, a Bulldog Lone Druid, and then a Lota Morana. Is this an aggressive tryline?
I mean, it could be S4 Morana mid. Because Lota in the past have played Dragonite quite a bit, in fact.
But that's so weak in a tri-lane. I think this is a Morana tri-lane.
I think if you ever get the disruption off as initiate, then your Dragon Tail should follow through as well. At the same time, if you get the disrupt and the arrow follow through, that's also very
good.
That's
true.
But I think as a mid, if you want to dominate the mid lane, Morana's just a little bit stronger, I think.
Yeah, she's got a very underwhelming attack, though. So, and it's kind of hard to hit arrows from mid. But she's decent at rune control. It could go either way. But I think one thing we know pretty much for sure is, well, obviously, Bulldog's on Lone Druid, and to me, it really looks like a safe lane Lone Druid. Probably against an offlane Darkseer. That's how it's looking right now.
Safe lane Lone Druid.
Because if you pick Shadow Demon, Enchantress, and Morana, it's just very odd to go defensive tri-lane.
Yeah, Tongfu gets very greedy here with their support. Going to pick up both Jakiro and Lion, especially Lion, who needs so much mana. And to be honest, if he gets disrupted ever, he's dead, right?
Yeah, so it's just pretty much.
His positioning has to be impeccable this game.
And then Song Sheng, to me, he's the one on Tongfu out of the two supports that has generally been the one who struggles with positioning. Banana's pretty safe in that regard.
He played pretty well last game.
Game he did.
Yeah.
But we saw a lot of moments where he was caught out in G1. So he'll have to bring his A game. That's
for
damn sure.
Players always improve. So, you know, if he played bad 2 months ago, we can't say he will play bad this tournament. Let's see if he has made that growth. I mean, they are doing well as a team. And of course, Alliance on the dire side. So far, you're 7-0 in Group B. EGM going up top on the Shadow Demon. We have Aki handling on jungling Enchantress. Lota is going to be playing your Morana. We have S4 on Dragonite. And last but not least, Emerald Bulldog with the Cauldron with a new set of the beer. I don't like this set personally. But
yeah. I like the panda bear.
The panda bear, yeah.
Yeah, it's also fun to kill pandas because you can't do it in real life.
It is not fun to kill pandas.
DPM was very mad at me, by the way. No more pandas in the BTS studio. On the side of Tongfu, the team that I think has come the closest to beating the Alliance in the International 3, but that's just based on what I've heard. We have not cast them too much ourselves. King J on the Darkseer. Mu, He's the solo mid playing the Weaver. You've got Banana, your four-position support on the Jakiro. How? Going solo mid as Alk, so it looks like they're going to switch up their lanes a bit here. How generally the safe laner occasionally does go mid for them, though. And Sungsheng going to be playing your support Lion. So, Lumi, you don't speak Russian.
I don't.
So don't worry about what Light of Heaven's saying, because okay. I see you trying to.
I'm trying to figure exactly what's going on right now. No really special item pickup just yet on anybody. So it's kind of your standard fare. Most people or two teams are kind of predicting their lane. In fact, they're going to go offensive here from Loda, Shadow Demon, as well as our Enchantress. So yeah. Normally,
it is offensive, but they defended their jungle.
Right. As we do see Mu going to select the Haste Rune here. In fact, it's going to go offensive the other way. Both teams deciding to go offensive tri lane. Let me talk quickly about that. I think, for example, if your Enchantress can't give the assistance to Loda and EGM, they're actually fine.
Level 1 smoke.
What's going on?
Are they going for first blood on Bulldog?
I mean.
No, S4. Not the easiest hero to gank.
They do have Hao charging up the stun.
No, not yet. He's got access to it, but S4 actually has to be, like, in the river. Like, he's got to be down
he's
more.
He's in the river now.
Only first split second. The trap has been sprung. First blood going to be attempted by Tong Fu. Impale to start. It's not a long stun for the Lion early on. A max duration nuke. Now you're dual breath. They need a few more right clicks, and they get him.
Good first blood. Yeah.
Alliance, I mean, this is great from Tong Fu because Alliance have gotten very comfortable against the Chinese teams that they get to set the tempo. And, well, Tong Fu set the tempo in game one.
I mean, two games in a row, right? Game number one, it was Tong Fu all over the place, ganking, just out-aggroing a team with a Bounty Hunter. This game, setting up the tempo right now with the first blood kill. And if your supports are just always kind of moving around the map, they're not getting ganked by that Enchantress in the jungle. And speaking of which, they're double jungling up for a little bit of EXP. They do not have a smoke of the Seether of their own.
So the bottom lane is a Weaver, but because you have Disruption and Arrow, if they get the chain stun right, Mu should be a potential kill. And then your mid lane Alk, I think that's a hero you can dive as well before he hits level 6. So Alliance have two lanes where they could find kills, but now Tong Fu are back to the jungle. So you talked about the Lion's positioning. Still no boots for Sungsheng, didn't get the first blood, and keeping that vision up is going to be crucial. Here we go. They're maybe looking for an arrow. Nah, too far away. Loda all the way back.
Sungsheng, got to be very careful. The net goes on. There is no arrow. There's no disruption, anything to follow through.
Well, he knows disruption's on cooldown. But yeah, now that it's back up, he'll have to be careful.
Yeah, you talked about the disruption being able to set up the arrow against Mu. That arrow has to land perfectly because Sungsheng perhaps in a tiny bit of trouble.
Okay, does have a slow here. The net's available in 1 second. Yeah, Sungsheng's not going to die, but Lion, you mentioned he's very level dependent, and he's getting zoned out of the lane. He's not getting those levels.
Yeah, I mean, the arrow could land on the Weaver and get the stun off, but at the same time, if he ever gets the Sakuchi off beforehand, there is no detection on the supports of Alliance. Oh, there is one Sentry Ward Enchantress, so they gotta make sure that gank particularly works out.
So we'll try and keep an eye on this lane of Bulldogs as well. So far, 9-1 to the 12-2 of Darkseer. I'd say KJ is doing pretty decently. He'll have his Soul Rain up soon. Bulldog should be getting good farm. When you run this tri lane, when you do this aggressive dual roam, it's to give Bulldog a lot of space as well. And right now, he's getting the space. Generally, we've seen him go usually Radiance, sometimes a Midas first if he's farming well or feels he can get away with it. We'll have to see what build he goes for this game.
Yeah, normally Darkseer has a fairly poor matchup against Longdrin, because Longdrin doesn't really care about the Iron Shell harass too much. You could just resummon Bear like he just did. And a lot of the hard work that King J has been doing is...
EGM, you know, he's got a tango here.
Although with that said, look at King J. He's found himself a huge stack, and that's a lot of gold going his way.
Yeah,
up.
Bulldog's going to come and contest it, but it's going to be hard to last hit against that many Ion Shells. It's going to be tough. Can he find the
Ooh,
last
got one.
He gets one big creep.
He's going to get the second one as well.
For another. That's pretty huge.
He's going to get the third one. Like, in fact, he's just winning right now.
Wow, he's getting every single one. And King J, now the Bulldog's level 5. If he gets rooted, that's first blood. He's going to need a surge. Is there that root? No root. That's a first blood if he gets it.
Yeah. Very, I guess, lucky here for King J.
It is. No, that was two auto attacks.
No cauldrons being raised just yet.
Cauldron gives you 75% increased chance to get an entangle.
For Loda, or for Bulldog, who always gets entangled, that was a rare miss.
Yeah, he's already got his Tranquil Boots up, and now he can be a lot more confident walking forward to right-click. King J did not go for any creep-skipping shenanigans. We just see him with his hero. He's just constantly in the lane, spamming Iron Shell. It's better to be on the Radiant side because of that pull, but not if Bulldog's just getting all those creeps.
Well, let's see how we've been doing on the mid lane here. After that first blood gank, Hao should be somewhat ahead. In fact, the thing that we haven't really talked about too much is Hao's playing solo mid.
Yeah, they do this sometimes just depending on heroes. It's not that common, but once in a while.
Yeah, Hao plays Weaver as well, so I'm surprised that they made that swap. But
I think it's I guess it's mostly like they wanted an Alchemid because they'd wanted to have the Weaver against what they thought would be a very aggressive Tri-Lane from Alliance. And Alk's a lot more vulnerable than a Weaver is.
Okay, that's definitely a fair point.
Seems like the reason anyway. We'd have to ask them to know. But Haystern up on Hound now. No TP just yet. Here comes the GG Tornado. For anyone who doesn't know, this Wildkin Tornado is probably the single most annoying spell in the laning phase.
I think Harpy Storm has eclipsed that.
It's pretty good.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
So for right now, do you give anyone an edge? Both teams, all three cores farming very evenly. Bulldog has his lone druid. If he wants a Midas, well, he's slowly working towards it. Who's ahead, Lumi?
I think Alliance is actually slightly ahead. I mean, you got to keep in mind that there is a first blood against S4, but S4 right now is actually leading in terms of CS. Although with that said, if you look at how he is actually ancient stacking by himself, so...
I think the one thing that I really like for Tongfu is their supports are actually out-leveling Alliance, despite Alliance having Enchantress.
Yeah, they have the Enchantress, but at the same time, because you are in the offensive jungle, you just feel the need that to put a little bit of pressure. And because they are putting a little bit of pressure, they're not farming as well. And also, they haven't really found the kill that they were looking for with that Disruption Arrow combo just yet.
Haystern is up on how. He popped it now. Actually popped it early. Normally, when you bottle a haste, you try and save it for the next turn so you can secure that as well. But does use it. He's going to farm some creeps here.
Yeah, he used it for the stacking so he could get back to lane quicker.
Okay. So, stacks the Ancients.
Yeah. And he's going at it again.
Oh, they could have made a go here on Loda, perhaps. EGM is near him, but now EGM's off the lane. So now Loda knows with Leap Down, with Disruption... not going to be near him. He'll have to play very defensively, at least until EGM gets back. And if you're Tongfu, maybe you look to strike now.
S4 is going to get himself a Illusion Rune. Both players were contesting it. I do want to mention that like this stack is hugely stacked up right now. I don't think he could actually contest it for himself.
Is he maxing Acid Spray? No, 2
not yet.
In it.
Yeah. Although S4, I think he has really kind of taken a big lead in the lane. He's already got level 6 before Alchemist does. He's CSing better despite the first blood.
Yeah, the thing is, once Dragonite hits level 6 in this matchup, it goes from being pretty even and maybe even favoring Alk to definitely favoring Dragonite. Because he can actually hit your tower, does a lot of damage sieging it. He's got the better initiation. Bottom lane, though, they've gone in on Loda. Could be our second kill of the game. He's got a leap. Oh, already used it. Dropping fast. One more right click. Disruption's in. Still running. They're still chasing. He bottles up EGM.
Arrow.
Another timely disruption.
Gonna hit on Banana, but...
yeah, but I don't think they can go on this.
Meanwhile, though, the bigger thing is that Aki has made a rotation up top.
Yeah,
Set up gank.
He's been up here.
Yeah, and Darkseer's dead. So, Emerald Bulldog getting the last on that one. So, no surprise there, Emerald Bulldog winning that particular matchup. It is already a favorable matchup, but the gank here from Aki just sealed the deal.
So, what is Bulldog going to go for? Just Boots, Stout Shield. Does he have... oh, there's your Midas recipe. It'll be that Midas build, and then, if left unchecked, he'll get the Radiance. Now, remember, Radiance does 50 burn damage per second. I believe one or two patches ago, it used to do 35, was it? Something like that. It's a lot stronger
it
now.
It used to be 35, and then it bumped it to 40, then 45, and now 50. Now, in this particular game, what a Radiance does is it'll eat your line alive. It'll force your Weaver to get tanky. It'll force your Jakiro to get an extra bracer or two. It is a big deal. There's really no way that Tongfu can deal with it. There's like no real item or no real way to kind of kill that bear quickly either. So I'm actually worried quite a bit. If this bear is left unchecked, and so far it is, it's going to go crazy.
Yeah, and so I think one thing that's worth talking about with his lone druid is a lot of people just have seen the Bulldog highlight reel. They've seen sort of a spectacular micro, and they're like, oh, sorry, bottom lane. They do kill off the Weaver, disruption into arrow, into a Starfall. Mm-hmm. Well-executed gank. And I mean, that is the nice thing. If you get that combo just right, Weaver has no chance to do anything. And there was a Sentry Ward here, so gets blown up. But that Bulldog's bear works largely because the rest of the team is so good at creating space for him. And that's what we see now. Constantly challenging the Ancients. Constant movement from Ake. Even though they weren't finding many kills
until
recently.
They could seal this Ancient. In fact, S4 is coming for it. Does he have his ultimate form? He does.
Only level 1, though. I mean, level 1 ult. House coming in. Hasted up as well. Maybe looking to go on Ake. Starts hitting him, but the heal's there. You probably want to go for S4, if anything. They'll try and work their way through Ake. Stun takes away about half his HP. Now he's dual breath. The heal's still flying. He will end up going down. But on the backside, S4, he's found a kill of his own. House still hasted up. He's got 10 stick charges here. Mirana ult's been used, but they do clip S4 with the ice path. Now, chasing Banana. He's going to go for this kill. How? Stick charges are up, still not channeling a stun. Now, S4 diving the tower as well. They're just very afraid to go.
Yeah, I mean,
he could have channeled a stun and tried to fight that.
And now, of course, now back to the Ancient. They're going to try at least steal one creep. 86 goals or something like that. How's going to get a stun on S4? Not really going to get too much done, but he wants this huge Ancient stack. That's a lot of levels. And Banana, of course, want that EXP as well.
Yeah, if you spam enough acid sprays, eventually the ancients will die, but it's taking a while for Hal. And right now they're giving the Jakir a little far mid, but nobody's defending the lane. So S4 continues to push. The tower already down to about half HP. Tong Fu, a four hero perimeter set up around this tower.
Also, King J has made a rotation from top to mid, so they're nobody.
They're four manny mid, and S4 still pushing. And while that's happening, Bulldog's free farming. But they will go in on S4 now. They might be able to kill him even with this disruption. Not sure if it'll be enough. Stun channel by Hal. Is it worth it, though? Bulldog, Midas already online. Now the Radiance clock begins. He's about to use it for the second time this game. Is it worth it, Lumi?
I mean, I don't think so, but they got to do what they got to do. Right now, Hao is just not having a good time on the mid lane. He's still stacking. He's still pulling. Hopefully, he gets a rune, although the Enchantress Centaur. Oh, no. Enchantress, the micro.
Oh, okay. He's such a nice guy, but man, when he plays Dota, he's a real dick.
Wow.
What a jerk.
He is quite
great. Great micro play, though. That was fantastic.
I just saw somebody pick up a Claymore. I think, yeah, that is Hao. So he's going to build the same build that he did last game where he had a ton of successes. But I think in this particular game, I think the Alliance team is going to be a lot more ready for it. First, you're dealing with the Weaver, so you're dealing with the Invincible Hero already. Secondly, you have Enchantress, one of the jungle support that could get a ton of early game farm. So you should have a pile of gold. So I think Alchemist Shadowblade is not going to have the similar start that he had last time.
Yeah, and the thing is, if you try to go for Shadowblade ganks, the heroes that you have to gank are very hard to kill. Dragon Knight's very, very tanky. Lone Druid especially. I mean, he's about to have level 2 bear form.
Hold that thought, Shen Sheng. Perhaps in a little bit of trouble. He got a juke to the left, and S4 does have his ultimate form. He's got Dredge, and Shen Sheng's got to turn around to Impale, to be honest.
If he turns around and gets disrupted, he'll actually be able to waddle away there.
Okay.
Does he have Tranquil Boots? No.
No, he just got basic boots and outran Dragon Knight with treads. That's surprising to me.
It gives you bonus move speed when you pop the ult. I was really surprised S4 didn't, but... And you've got the range stun as well, but he decides not to. While that's happening, the Root Lord finds another kill in King J top. Now Mu on the run. Loda holding an arrow, looking for a kill. Mu juking into the trees. Loda still hunting. The cat is hunting the roach.
Mu is being way too scared for his Sakuchi. I mean, he just Sakuchi 3 times, and he's out of mana 4 time-lapse. There's a Sentry War on the ground. He has 1 time-lapse left with 0 magic stick.
And he's going to get disrupted. Look for the arrow to fly, Loda. Oh, here we go. Is it going to be on the market?
Oh.
Not, but they get a Dragon Tail anyway, and now Mu is dead.
Again, Mu was safely behind his Tier 1 tower with time-lapse up. He ran all the way to the Secret Shop for basically no reason. And just trapped himself. And now suddenly Banana's in a little bit of awkward position.
Okay, Bulldog's up to 2.5k gold.
I mean, it's a lost cause.
He's going to have a relic.
Bulldog
at
is a lost
cause. You can't ignore Lone Druid. You can't ignore this hero. That's the problem.
I agree with you, but Tong Fu's ignoring him.
Like, if he gets the tower, which he probably will in the next few minutes, they're already getting a tower.
Arrow's
going to fly.
Oh my god.
Great juke by him. Almost in range of a disruption or a purge, but just a little bit out. It's got to come down to Hao. This Shadow Blade for Hao has to be effective. They almost got a mech on King J. They cannot, even though they've got Grievous Greed, they've got some heroes that scale with farm, but not. You can't go for farm when Bulldog already has a Midas, is going to have a relic in maybe 14, at the 14-minute mark at the latest. But you just can't. You have to go and fight.
I mean, right now they're getting 5v4'd. Alliance is winning at 5v4.
You know, one big thing about this game as well is Lone Druid is probably the best carry in the game against Darkseer because you don't make a copy of the bear with the wall. So the bear just runs in and it'll kill off all the illusions really quickly. And you can siege all day. Normally, Darkseer, one of the best high ground defense heroes in the game, not so good against Lone Druid.
I mean, at the same time, Acid Spray as well as just Concentrated Right Click will actually deal with the bear. You have things like Hexes, you have things like Impale, a ton of like range AoE stuns and slow. So I think they are still in theory capable of defending against it, but it just depends on what else you throw away. I mean, if S4 gets big enough on that Dragon Knight, suddenly he is also just a ranged siege machine, and you cannot ignore him. But we're going to see a gank attempt up top, because Hao is making the rotation, he's waiting for the Shadow Blade to come, and is he in ultimate form? He is not. So this first gank, very, very important.
While that's happening...
No, he goes into ultimate form. Alright, gank's done.
While that's happening, though, the Alliance is wrapping around as well. Two heroes on the bottom lane, smoked up. They're going to walk right over their own Sentry Ward soon. There's a TP here as well. It comes from Hao, but I think he's too late to save Mu. There's your disruption. Arrow to fly. On the mark. Nails it. Dead Mu once again.
Wow.
Somebody did call for an exterminator, and its name is Loda.
Yeah, and I look at the amount of Sentry Ward in that lane here. That particular Observer Ward will see Hao, and they are completely ready. He's charging up a stun. Is there a trap waiting for him? No, he's going to just stun himself in the face because...
Yeah, he'll be okay here, but... Yeah, that's not good. One minor thing I do want to point out about Bulldog and just Lone Druid play in general is one of the nice things you can do is actually put your Midas on your hero before you use it, so your hero benefits from the experience. And also when it's on cooldown, when you can't use it, put it back on the bear for the attack speed, which generally he does. We're not seeing it right now, but just something to keep in mind is swapping the Midas here back and forth is very efficient.
We're going to see yet another gank going towards Hong Fu. Hao is just running fast, running strong. Double sentry gets dropped here.
Well, this is not a good place for Tong Fu. Like, this is a very bad place for them. But while that's happening, hasted up S4, just runs away mid, takes a tier 1 and gets out. I mean, that's Grand Theft Tower from S4. Now he's even heading top.
Might Tower even go for Courier? Courier micro that thing. Oh,
no.
God.
Oh, man.
All right, good.